Welcome all, it's Russ, and in this video, we finally get to talk about how to do an if statement. And you've actually seen this in the very first video, I already gave a hint of it, but let me show it to you officially here. In Python, an if statement is simply the word if, followed by a condition, and then a colon. Unlike some other languages, there's no parentheses that are required here. So if A equals B colon print X, you can have an else statement if you want, print Y. And that's a complete if statement. Now, what are the variants on it? Well, of course, one of the options is you don't need an else statement, as you're probably able to guess. You might want to do an elif. So an elif is the equivalent of an else if in C or in Python. So you could say elif C equals D, we will print Y. If you want, you can have a whole chain of elifs followed by an else at the very bottom. What about compound statements? Can you do those in Python? You can, but Python doesn't support like the ampersand operator that you may have seen in some other languages. In Python, we literally write something. If A equals B and E equals F, so there's your and operator. You've also got, of course, the or operator and the not operator. And you can use parentheses as necessary for combining these. Occasionally, you may need to write a very long if statement. An if statement with a very long condition. Python, remember that Python defines the structure of its statements based on indentation, based on individual lines. So you can't just run your conditions off onto another line, right? In C, you could do something like if A equals B and E equals F and G equals H and I equals J. That's not going to work in Python, because it's looking at indentation. Python does allow you to break something into two lines with a trailing backslash. So if the very last character of your line is a backslash, then Python pretends that there wasn't a line break and just keeps reading the next line from there. So trying to think, I think that's actually the key things you need to know about if statements, how they work in Python, what the syntax looks like. We have all the same basic operators you're familiar with. And, or, and not are written out as words. We've got the equals equals. We've got a not equals operator, less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, all those things. And it pretty much works like any other language that you've seen before. Let's do a nested if. So nested if is a good chance to look at how Python uses indentation to track the blocks you're in. So let's say if A equals B, and then we'll have inside of it, if C equals D, print an X, and now we'll have else print Y. All right, so this is a classic problem from computer science, is the question of how to parse this. Because if you just read it off without caring about indentation, there's two reasonable ways you could interpret this. You could say that this if is connected to this else, or you could say that this if is connected to the else. In C++, in Java, in JavaScript, the way we solve this is by putting in curly braces at specific locations to group blocks together. But in Python, we solve this with indentation. So what you'll notice here is that when we go into the true block of the if, there's a line here with everything lined up nicely. When we go into the block of if, we start a new indentation level that had never existed before. So Python sees a colon followed by indentation. It says, ah, yeah, we're inside the body of the if block. Totally reasonable. Now it sees another colon and another indentation level. So now it says, we're inside the body of the second if. Fair enough. Nothing particularly remarkable here. Now it hits this else statement and it says, huh, we're not at this deep indentation level anymore. Okay, well, I guess this if block has ended. And it goes back out to this level. Oh, we're not there either. So what it says is that this whole if block has ended as well. So this if is connected to this else. And we know that because they're lined up together. That does mean that you have to be pretty rigorous about your indentation. You can't be +1 or -1 on your indentation. You'll actually get syntax errors and your program won't even run. So by indentation, we know that this else is part of this if. All right, now that you know that, I think you can now build arbitrarily complex if statements, and you can replicate anything you've done in a different language. All right, hope that's useful. Hope you learned a lot. Bye-bye.